where previous some of the classes we discussed that what is tuberculosis, what are the various types of TB, such as multi-drug resistance tuberculosis, then extensively drug resistance tuberculosis, and this is one more type of tuberculosis that is called TDR-TB, basically total drug resistant tuberculosis. So we have identified, we have discussed these three types of the TB, and basically these types of TB are based upon the resistance which against to of resistance of Mycobacterium tuberculosis against several drugs which are maybe first line agents or second line agents. So we have discussed so many things under that basically this Mycobacterium tuberculosis is the infectious pathogenic microorganism for the cause of tuberculosis, the TB. And we have seen some of the symptoms of TB that it causes cough. Patients will have coughing, sneezing, fever, weight loss. That is one of the major, one of the characteristics in tuberculosis, that patient will lose his weight. And loss of the appetite, that and because of that patient will feel weakness and nights time sweating, etc. So these are the kinds of symptoms which can be seen in the patients. And if we take the X-ray of such patients, so it will be like this, which is on your screen, and that highlights that the patient is having somehow pulmonary tuberculosis. One more thing I would like to express here, that why Mycobacterium tuberculosis only affect the lungs majorly. There are several types of TB which can affect kidney, which can affect brain or something else. Why Mycobacterium tuberculosis majorly affects lungs? So the reason behind is that this Mycobacterium tuberculosis is aerobic bacteria, and aerobic bacteria are the one which require the oxygen. And there are several organs in our body. Lungs are one of the organs which are having plenty of oxygen to themselves. That's why whatever the mycobacteria oxygen is their requirement. So this major requirement which will be satisfied in the lungs. So that's why Mycobacterium tuberculosis will be happy to make their homes. They will be happy to multiply and grow in the lungs, and then they can cause these kinds of pulmonary tuberculosis. So if there is a question that why Mycobacterium tuberculosis majorly affect the lungs, so you should answer like this, that these bacteria are aerobic bacteria, and aerobic bacteria are one of the bacteria for whose survival oxygen is mandatory. And such oxygen, which can be the part of, let us oxygen majorly obtained from the lungs, because we whatever the inhalation and exhalation we are doing, so that is lungs, that will be carried out in the lungs. So Mycobacterium tuberculosis will majorly found in lungs. Then we have seen some of the drugs. You can see that 1938, the some of the drugs which have been used for the treatment of TB, and still we are using the same drugs. And just like we discussed in some one of our previous sessions, that TB is the disorder where more than 46 years only three drugs have been approved for treatment of tuberculosis. Only three drugs in last 46 years. And there was a time that last 40 years there was not a single drug. 40 साल में कोई भी दवाई मार्केट में आई नहीं थी. आई मीन टू से न्यू मेडिसिन, न्यू ड्रग, न्यू ट्रीटमेंट फॉर टीबी. तो दिस इज बेसिकली वन ऑफ द चैलेंजिंग डिसऑर्डर. यू आइडेंटिफाई WHO रिपोर्ट फ्रॉम यू इंटरनेट. इन ईच एंड एवरी ईयर WHO पब्लिशेस अ वर्ल्ड ट्यूबरक्लोसिस और ग्लोबल टीबी रिपोर्ट. एंड इफ वी सी द नंबर्स इन दिस रिपोर्ट, where how many numbers of patients of TB have been infected due to TB. So these numbers are in millions, 12, 13 millions, and 1 million is equal to 12 lakh, 1 million is equal to 10 lakh. So if I say 12 million number of patients, so that means 120 lakhs patients of TB. So that is a huge number. And Now, so several millions of patients are dying because of TB. More than 2 million, so 20 lakh people die around due to tuberculosis. And if we try to identify how much patients in an hour, how many patients in a day, how many patients in a second, so there will be death of nearly one patient in 20 seconds. 20 seconds, and it is a death of one patient of TB. So this way, the numbers are very huge. 2 million people in 365 days, so around one patient in 20 seconds. So that is a big number. So we can understand how many, what is the this pandemic due to TB. Okay, so these are the drugs which are used. So only three drugs have been approved in previous years, but last 46 years. Bedaquiline, which is one of the drugs containing quinoline moiety. Another drug, pretomanid, which is, has been approved last year in August 2019, that is having nitroimidazole class of derivative. The third drug which has been approved by European Medical Agency, that is delamenide. So these are the three drugs which have been approved for treatment of TB in last 46 years. Or ye dawai wo hai, which is on your screen, which we are using since 1940s. Right, so there will be since last more than 80 years we are using the same medications, although there is lot of advancements of technologies. We are previously there were no computers, but now they are. So par phir bhi hum 1940 ke zamane ka hi dawai aaj bhi use kar rahe hain, and these drugs are effective. Some of the drugs are much more effective, first line drugs such as isoniazid and rifampicin, ethambutol, and paraminosalicin, streptomycin. So I think this paraminosalicylic and streptomycin are second line drugs. Okay, but still we are using streptomycin is here in first line drugs. So these are the classification of the drugs, first line drugs and second line NTP drugs, according to their efficacy and less toxicity. So first line drugs are less toxic and having least chances of resistance. What are they? Ethambutol, isoniazid, pyrazinamide, rifampicin and streptomycin. So the three letter code or one letter code have been highlighted here, just like ethambutol, EMB, one letter code is E. Streptomycin, three letter code is STM and one letter code is S. All these are first line drugs. And secondly, second line drugs are basically which are having more toxicity and less efficacy. Maybe sometimes they are used when resistance is the problem. So although these are the drugs which have more chances of the resistance, such as aminoglycoside, which has been taught by one of the other faculty of the institute to you people, amikacin and kanamycin, these are the aminoglycosides. Fluoroquinolones, such as ciprofloxacin and levofloxacin. So these are fluoroquinolones, which are DNA gyrase or topo2 inhibitors. So they are also used as this kinds of second line NTPV drugs. Ethionamide or thiomides. So that is also another drug. Paraaminosalicylic acid, which is a small molecule, just a derivative of salicylic acid. And we know salicylic acid is key material for synthesis of aspirin. That is also having somehow kind of this anti-TB activity. Several peptides and cycloserine, which is an antibiotic. Cycloserine is basically D-alanine analog. That is also used as a second line anti-TB agents or second line anti-TB drugs. So friends, we have seen up to this much in the last class, and this is the classification based upon their chemical motif or chemical structure, according to which is present in their skeleton. Such as the salicylic acid, paraminosalicylic acid is the example of salicylic acid derivative. Pyridine derivative, so pyridine ring, 1-azabenzene. Benzene ke kisi bhi carbon pe aap nitrogen put karo, draw karo, so that moiety is called as pyridine. 1-azabenzene. So that is basically pyridine. So this isoniazid, ethionamide, and some other drugs, prothionamide. So basically all of them are pyridine derivatives. Pyrazine derivatives. If we draw the structure of benzene, let me draw the structure of benzene. It will be much more, not difficult, impossible, but let us say what is called pyrazine. So if we draw the structure of benzene having three alternate single bonds, three alternate double bonds. So this is the benzene. At the first position, if I put this nitrogen, so now it is pyridine derivative 1-azobenzene. This is your class, I mean. If I say pyrazine, so pyrazine is basically this will be pyrazine. If I put nitrogen at this position, so this will become pyrazine 1,4 diazo benzene. Ethylene diamine butanol, so that is again ethan butol, and streptomycin, basically some other antibiotics, rifampicin. Ensamycin, class of antibiotic, or kanamycin, again, aminoglycoside. So all these are covered under. Some other miscellaneous drugs, again, fluoroquinolones, which is having phenolene moiety. You know what is phenolene? One as a naphthalene, so that is quinoline. If you just draw a simple naphthalene string structure, bicyclic ring, which are connected with each other. So the one first position, if you put nitrogen, so that will become this. Quinoline and quinolones, which will have carbon oxygen double bond on this structure. Okay, so we will visit that structure, but the same class classifications which can be useful to classify several drugs available in the category of NTTB. Okay, so up to this we have covered in some of the last classes on NTTB agents or antimicrobacterial drugs, or anti-tubercular drugs, or anti-TB drugs. Okay, so now coming to this another drug, which is isonicotic acid hydrazide, or hydrazine. Basically, it is also called as isoniazide. So now, why it is called isonicotinic acid? Because if you see the structure of nicotinic acid, so if I draw the structure of nicotinic acid will look like this. I will have to take my pen tool, or else I can draw here, because already, no, I cannot do that. Because I have put the nitrogen. So let me draw the structure of benzene, and I will draw this numbered cyclic ring having three alternate double bonds, three alternate single bonds. This is benzene. If I put nitrogen over here, so now it is pyridine. Okay. So after that, if I put here at third position, if I write COOH, this COOH is basically pyridine 3 carboxylic acid. Thanks. Pyridine 3 carboxylic acid, wo aur koi nahi hai. That is actually this isonicotinic acid. Sorry, that is basically this nicotinic acid, not isonicotinic acid. So, pyridine 3 carboxylic acid is nicotinic acid, but pyridine 4 carboxylic acid, which is here, that is isonicotinic acid. Or if you carboxylic acid ka, if we react with NH2, which is hydrazine, you will be using the same substance in synthesis of this phenytoin from benzene. Aapne already synthesis learned kiya hai, and when the college will start, you will learn the synthesis of phenytoin. You do it practically. So this is basically pyridine 3 carboxylic acid, nicotinic acid, or uska hi isomer pyridine 4 carboxylic acid. But if this carboxylic acid COOH is reacted with NH2, it will remove the water molecule and will form such hydrazide. Hydrazine, say hydrazide. Initially it was hydrazine, NH2. Tap synthesis, maybe you will see later on. I am not sure. Ah, yeah. So here it is. You can see this. carbapenemidine 4 carboxylic acid if it is treated with hydrazine NH2NH2. So it will remove the water molecule and will form isoniazide or isonicotyl acid hydrazide. Okay. So this, friends, this molecule has been synthesized in 1952. So there are more than 70 years since the discovery of isonicotyl acid. Okay. फिर भी आज वही की वही मेडिसिन वी आर लर्निंग वी आर यूजिंग वी नॉट डेवलपिंग सम न्यू मॉलिक्यूल 1952 का मॉलिक्यूल है फिर भी आज वो एकदम तरोताजा है नया है और पॉपुलर ड्रग फर्स्ट लाइन एंटीटीबी ड्रग वेरी स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल जस्ट बेंजीन स्ट्रक्चर एंड हैविंग CO(NH)NH2 सो यू कैन इट्स मॉलिक्यूलर वेट मे बी लेस देन 200 राइट आई एम बंजीन का 17 और बाकी सारे एटम का कैलकुलेट करो तो वेरी स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल हैविंग मॉलिक्यूलर वेट अबाउट 200 ग्राम पर मोल और डाल्टन. ओके सो दिस इज अ फर्स्ट लाइन एंटीटीबी ड्रग व्हिच इज हैविंग बैक्टीरियोस्टेटिक एक्शन इट इज आल्सो नोन एज आइसोनियाजाइड. नाम ही ऐसा है कि उसमें उसका पूरा जो फंक्शन है वो कवर हो जाता है जस्ट लाइक लेट अस गो टू दिस हाइलाइटिंग माय pen tool again. So you see this isoni, so that represents isonicotinic acid. Azide, that is basically represents hydrazide. Right? So usi se ye chota sa naam banaya hai isoniazide. This is the name of the drug which is a pyridine derivative and that is one of the cheapest antitubercular drugs. Cheapest isliye kyunki it is much easy to synthesize. बस आप पिरिडिन 3 कार्बोक्सिलिक पिरिडिन 4 कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड ले लो और उसका हाइड्राजाइड बना दो आपका ड्रग तैयार है इन 1 or 2 स्टेप्स. ओके सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज चीपर. जैसे कोई एंटीबायोटिक है तो उसका यू विल नो दैट हाउ इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू कल्चर द एंटीबायोटिक दैट्स व्हाई इट विल बी कॉस्टली एज वेल. व्हाट इज द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन? द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन इज सेड टू बी दैट दिस इज द ड्रग व्हिच इज गोइंग टू ऑक्सीडाइज टू बेसिकली it is a prodrug. Isoniazide is called as a prodrug. So this is a peroxidase enzyme will convert into several aldehyde, carboxylic acid, and carboxamide. Or aisa bhi kaha jata hai ki it is going to make the complex with one of the vitamin B6. I mean to say, vitamin B6 pyridoxine. So in that it will create another complex. So इसीलिए जब isoniazide दिया जाता है then it is necessary to give the supplements of vitamin B6, pyridoxine, because this drug is having a side effect and can cause to be vitamin B6 is a side effect that can be caused by this drug also. But mechanism of action says that once it is a prodrug, it will may oxidize to some of this. And this oxidation is achieved by this peroxidase enzyme. If now recent literature also says that this is a drug, basically this is act on some acyl carrier NHA protein. I mean to say, mechanism of action is this INHA. It is going to inhibit this proteinous enzyme. I, the name here. INH capital A. So this is the least recent mechanism of action of this drug. It is going to inhibit this INHA or INHA enzyme. Okay. And basically it inhibits the cell wall synthesis and going to inhibit the cell wall synthesis of mycobacterium. Then next coming to the structure activity relationship so of isoniazide. So as you can see on your script title that this is a isoniazide. Once we can how to synthesize it, so that is given over here and these are somehow structure activity relationship. So structure activity relationship basically a com medicinal chemistry point of view, it means how structure can be correlated with ये थोड़ा बहुत 3-4 पॉइंट लिखा हुआ है. सो इट्स सच एज N1 नाइट्रोजन इन हाइड्राजाइड साइड चेन शुड बी अनसब्स्टिट्यूटेड. ये जो N1 है, यू कैन सी हियर, सो दैट N1 शुड बी अनसब्स्टिट्यूटेड, शुड नॉट बी N2 नाइट्रोजन कैन बी सब्स्टिट्यूटेड विथ अल्काइल ग्रुप्स. So if we can also substitute the alkyl groups, and depending upon the chain of the alkyl groups, as this is somehow activity. जैसे यहाँ पे लिखा है कि R2 is isopropyl group, then isopropyl derivative iproniazide. So that is synthesized and it is having somehow activity as of isoniazide, but it is also shows some of the psychomotor stimulant. Okay, so friends, this is the structure of the activity. This NH should be free and this N2 can be alkylated and it can be methyl ethyl isopropyl. But isopropyl is much more effective. It is a derivative of this isopropyl derivative that is called iproniazide. That is having somehow biological activity, NTTB activity, as well as psychomotor stimulant activity. So basically, it is kind of stimulatory action on psychomotor cells. They are related with the brain and related with the movement. So these kinds of what is the synthesis? Synthesis is that we know if we have 4-methylpyridine, which is a commercially available chemical, a very small molecule having methyl position at the fourth of this pyridine. So if it is oxidized to this isonicotinic acid, I mean to say pyridine 4-carboxylic acid, then this pyridine 4-carboxylic acid, it is called isonicotinic acid. If it is reacted with NH2 hydrazine, this ammonia, that is NH3, but though ammonia molecule ek saath nitrogen bonded hai, so that is called hydrazine. So this hydrazine, which can form useful to make this isoniazide. Okay, so that's why here in we are discussing structure activity relationship of isoniazide. Okay, so friends, now next is the this mechanism of action of this isoniazide or metabolism of isoniazide. So I have taken this metabolism of isoniazide from one of the reference book, and this is highlighted on your So isoniazide is basically metabolized in the liver by acetylation. And there are two forms of this enzyme which is responsible for acetylation, and you will come to know that this isoniazide is basically observed in different people. N-acetyl isoniazide, that is there. So here is only the difference is this will undergo acetylation. और भी एक है जैसे ये कोई और बना है बट दैट इज समहाउ एसिटिक एसिड का और प्रोपियोनिक एसिड के साथ उसका एक अदर डेरिवेटिव है. हियर एन एसिटाइल आइसोनियाजाइड दैट कैन अंडरगो मेटाबॉलिज्म टू आइसोनिकोटिनिक एसिड एंड हाइड्राजिन, सो दैट विल बी लिबरेटेड इनटू द बॉडी. एसिटाइल हाइड्राजाइड भी बन सकता है और उससे वो डाई एसिटाइल हाइड्राजाइड भी बन सकता है. दिस आर द थिंग्स विच कैन अकर टू आवर बॉडी. तो बेसिकली मेटाबॉलिज्म का पर्पज ही वही होता है. Whatsoever the drugs are there, so they will be metabolized to small polar molecules. So polar molecules that which are easily water soluble can be solubilized into urine, and then they can be excreted from the body. So these are very much more polar molecules having ketone, amide, and acid or NH2. Here is also acid. Here is also acid. So carboxylic acid is naturally more polar than this hydrazide. Yeah. So that is the effect of metabolism. Here basically it will be called as cannabolism, the destructive approach or destruction of isoniazide into polar molecules. So that way USF got in most of the US population, this half-life is basically 1 to 3 hours for this kind of. Okay, yeah, so this is the adverse effects. तो वैसे पहले भी मैं आपको बोल चुका हूँ कि दिस आइसोनियाजाइड व्हिच मेक्स द कॉम्प्लेक्स विद विटामिन B6 इज आइदर पाइरिडॉक्सिल और पाइरिडॉक्सिन और पाइरिडॉक्सल. ओके, सो इट विल मेक वन कॉम्प्लेक्स, आल्सो उसमें भी NADH भी होता है. इफ यू रिफर बायोकेमिस्ट्री बाय सत्य नारायण. सो यू विल कम टू नो अंडर द विटामिन चैप्टर करके एक अलग से है, विटामिन बी कॉम्प्लेक्स है और उसमें दिस विटामिन बी सिक्स डिस्कस. यू विल ऑल्सो कम टू नो दैट विटामिन बी सिक्स विल मेक सर्टेन कॉम्प्लेक्स विद एनएडीएच एंड आइसोनियाज़िड. जब भी पेशेंट को आइसोनियाज़िड दिया जाता है, पेशेंट विल डेवलप दिस साइड इफेक्ट पेरिफेरल न्यूरोपैथी विच इज अ डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ विटामिन बी सिक्स. दैट्स व्हाई पेशेंट इफ यू वांट टू एंड इट विल कॉज डेप्लेशन द डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ विटामिन बी सिक्स इन सच टीबी पेशेंट्स. सो इफ यू वांट टू रिटेन दिस बेसिकली आई मीन टू से the level of vitamin B6 into the patient's body, then supplements of vitamin B6 has to be given from outside or in terms of tablets or other way, along with this anti-TB drug, isoniazid. So this way we can overcome, and it has been mentioned that vitamin B6 is given together with the isoniazid to rectify or to remove the toxic reactions of isoniazid. Okay, this is the adult dose of the vitamin B6, which is this is the adult dose of isoniazid is at 50 milligram maybe, and it is used in continuation period. You will come to know that DOTS therapy, directly observed treatment short course, where this treatment is isoniazid. Okay, so we are not going to touch much more about pharmacological aspects, although we are in medicinal chemistry point of view. So we will be discussing only the concerns where medicinal chemistry is there. Okay, so the SAR, metabolism and synthesis. So in this DOTS therapy, what they are doing, basically this is a 6-month course where isoniazid and rifampicins are given. These two drugs are later on stops after 2 months, and then another 4 months. Sorry, these two drugs should stop after 2 months, and another 4 months, some other isoniazid and rifampicin. So, this isoniazid, rifampicin, pyrazinamide, and ethambutol are given, and after 2 months, we should stop this pyrazinamide and ethambutol, and later for next 4 months, this isoniazid and rifampicin should be given to the patient. And this is a part of treatment of, or here we want to highlight the use of. Okay, after this isoniazid, we have seen the structure. It is 4 nicotinic acid and its structure relationship synthesis and therapeutic. Side effect is majorly it can cause this deficiency of vitamin. Or BX side effect, which is not mentioned on the slide. This drug can cause hepatotoxicity. Very much detrimental to the liver. It can cause a toxicity to the liver. Okay? Because of the metabolism of the cytochrome enzymes. So maybe it is inhibiting one of the CYP enzymes, CYP450, CYP450. So that's why this is also a hepatotoxic drug, which can cause toxicity of liver or sometimes may cause the liver failure as well. So that's why if we want to, this is not a good choice of the drug, because 6 mahina patients ko ye diya jata hai, so it can cause the failure of liver. We know that liver is one of the largest organ of the body, and it is the metabolic factory. Whatever the we are eating, and if we want to digest it, so liver is essential because it is a source of bile juice as well as bile pigments, along with several enzymes which are required for metabolism and anabolism. Okay, another hepatotoxic drug. So this drug is also a hepatotoxicity, can cause hepatotoxicity, but this is also used as anti-TB drug. Right, here is a structure of that drug, very simple structure. There is no any kind of aromatic ring in its structure. Completely aliphatic molecule. Naturally, it is alcohol. I mean to say here, in this case, it is secondary alcohol. Because this is a carbon, which a primary alcohol, sorry. So this is oxygen, which is connected with a carbon, and another carbon is connected with one of the carbons. बेसिकली इट इज प्राइमरी अल्कोहल इथाम ब्यूटोल, इसीलिए उसका जो नाम में जो ये ओएल रिप्रेजेंट है ना, जैसे आप इथेनॉल, ब्यूटेनॉल, मिथेनॉल, तो उसका जो लास्ट का ओएल, तो दैट ओएल रिप्रेजेंट्स के, तो इसीलिए जो अल्कोहल है तो इसीलिए उसको इथाम ब्यूटोल नाम दिया। नेचुरली ब्यूट नाम है, ब्यूट नाम से तो ब्यूटेन तो होगा ही, तो वेर इज दैट ब्यूटेन, हाँ हियर इट इज ब्यूटेन, 1, 2, 3 एंड 4, 4, तो ब्यूटेनॉल तो है ही, राइट, सो ब्यूटोल नाम दे दिया है। इथाम इसलिए बोला होगा, इथ तो वेर एवर इथ इज देयर, सो दैट रिप्रेजेंट्स इथाइल ग्रुप, सो इज देयर एनी इथाइल ग्रुप, या सो हियर इट इज CH2, CH2, और AM stands for amino, so here it is amino, NH, NH, and basically this is ethylene diamine, right? तो इसीलिए यहाँ पे नाम है amino, और उसका दूसरा नाम है ethylene diamine butanol, ठीक? तो ये जो पूरा ड्रग है, that is completely aliphatic one, and it is two isomers. एक्स्ट्रा आइसोमर एज 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 वेल एज लीवो आइसोमर। सो यू इफ यू अप्लाई योर नॉलेज ऑफ स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री व्हिच यू स्टडीड इन ऑर्गेनिक बेसिक ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, सो यू विल कम टू नो हियर दिस इज अ कार्बन सेंटर, दैट इज अ काइरल कार्बन। व्हाई इट इज अ काइरल कार्बन? बिकॉज काइरल कार्बन्स आर द वंस व्हिच आर कनेक्टेड विद फोर डिफरेंट कार्बन्स और फोर डिफरेंट फंक्शनल ग्रुप्स। सो हियर दिस इज कनेक्टेड विद CH2OH, here ethyl, here hydrogen, and here some other function group. Okay, so I mean to say that this is a carbon, it is present in the structure of ethyl butyl, is chiral carbon. Okay. Another carbon is here, similarly. Again, H, CH2, CH2, CH2OH, and this remaining functional group. Right? So there are two carbon centers to this molecule. And according to Wontoff's law, 2:2, that means there can be four isomers of this molecule. One will be levo, other will be dextro, then it can be racemic or and some other. Okay, just like in other words, I can say if this is R, 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 one isomer, R, S, second isomer, SR, third isomer, SS, fourth isomer, right? So this way, this drug, which can possess total four isomers. आपको पता है ना कैपिटल आर और कैपिटल एस द नोमेनक्लेचर व्हिच हैज बीन गिवन बाय द साइंटिस्ट, थ्री साइंटिस्ट, कहान, इल्गोल्ड एंड प्रीलॉग. सो दीज आर द थ्री साइंटिस्ट हु हैव गिवन दिस नोमेनक्लेचर आर एंड एस. That nomenclature यहाँ पर भी आता है, आप determine कर सकते हो इसका भी, similarly whether it is clockwise, anti-clockwise, उसके लिए आपको priority भी देना पड़ेगा. Okay, but we will not go into the depth because we want to apply the knowledge of that stereochemistry with the medicinal chemistry. So what does medicinal chemistry says? Medicinal chemistry says that dextro isomer of the ethambutol is almost 500 times more potent than the levo iso or meso isomer. And meso isomer is called extra levo meso. Okay, so this is a molecule which we can cut into two equal parts. I mean, to from this, दोनों को एक equal part में convert कर सकते हैं. या आप 2HCl थोड़ी देर के लिए भूल जाओ. ये 2HCl लिखना, basically it is hydrochloride salt. भूल जाओ, वी कैन उसको बीच में से इफ वी कट एंड वी कैन मेक इट ए सिमेट्रिकल मॉलिक्यूल एज ए सिमेट्री, राइट, दैट्स व्हाई मेसो आइसोमर तभी होता है जैसे टार्टरिक एसिड में होता है. सो हियर इट इज आल्सो देयर विद दिस. ओके, सो डेक्स्ट्रो आइसोमर इज एक्टिव, लिवो आइसोमर इज फार्माकोलॉजिकली इनर्ट, सो दैट इज नॉट दैट मच. Water soluble, ठीक है, and these are the other things which are bacterial. Fine. So as we have discussed some of the concepts that the presence of two amino moiety that is essential for their biological activity, And when amino acids are replaced with some other acetyl group, sulfonyl group, or nitrosyl group, then their activity is completely abolished or removed. Okay. And when heteroatoms such as oxygen, sulfur, etc., they are used, so activity is जो नेचुरली जैसे ही मेडिसिनल केमिस्ट्री में होता है कि आप वो कंपाउंड इसको रिप्लेस करो तो इंक्रीज होती है और डिक्रीज होती है. सो यू कैन रीड दैट ऑल्सो. नेक्स्ट टाइम आई शैल ऑल्सो शेयर द स्लाइड्स विद यू सो दैट यू कैन ऑल्सो गो थ्रू दिस. ओके नाउ अगेन व्हाट इज द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ दिस. सिमिलरली दिस इज इथाम्ब्यूटोल. दिस ड्रग इज ऑल्सो हैविंग बैक्टीरियोस्टेटिक एक्शन. And it is involving in cell wall. It will inhibit the cell wall synthesis of mycobacterium tuberculosis by inhibiting this arabinogalactan synthesis, and it will going to inhibit this enzyme, arabinosyl transferase. Right? So this medicine can be. If you want to refer the pharmacology of these drugs, then pharmacology by K.D. Tripathi, then pharmacology by Ranga and Dale. These are the most appropriate books to refer the pharmacological actions of. But medicinal chemistry point of view, we may refer Wilson and Wilson, so or we may refer this William, or we may refer this Foy. Foy is medicinal chemistry. So that is that. Okay, so ये जो आपका था with mechanism of action, it is arabinosyl transferase inhibition. And this basically a metabolite, so which can be metabolized to ethambutol and metabolite A and metabolite B. So basically, yeah. And it is sometimes remain excreted unchanged, 73%. So since itself is a polar molecule, आप देखोगे तो it possesses alcohol and amine. So itself is a polar molecule and it can be easily excreted. So about more than one third of the drug. Or more than sorry, two, you can say more than third part of administered dose is excreted unchanged in the form of urine out of from the body. Okay, so this is metabolism of butanol, and both the metabolites are devoid of biological activity, and they are so that's why this is not a prodrug. Prodrug hota to iska jo ye dono metabolite hai. वो एक्टिव होने चाहिए बट दे आर डाइलेटिव. कमिंग टू द सिंथेसिस, हाउ कैन वी सिंथेसाइज इथाम्ब्यूटोल. सो इफ वी हैव द दिस 1,2 डाइक्लोरोइथेन व्हिच इज अ कमर्शियली अवेलेबल एंड वेरी स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल, इफ वी ट्रीट दिस विद 2 अमीनो 1 ब्यूटेनॉल, देन विद इट विल रिमूव सम 2 हाइड्रोक्लोराइड सॉल्ट्स एंड दिस इथाम्ब्यूटोल कैन बी राइट. सो यू कैन सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस 2 amino butanol, and this way. Friends, how? What are the other physicochemical properties? Yeah, so they have mentioned it is odorless, bitter, and soluble in water and alcohol, etc. Toxicity. So some of the toxicity are given, but the major toxicity is optical neuritis. Patient ko jab bhi ethambutol diya jata hai, there is a risk. That patient will lose the vision. And this is a major side effect of this ethambutol, the loss of vision or decreased vision, or even patient will lose the ability to differentiate the red, green, or blue color. So here they have mentioned only red and green. So this is a major side effect. ये तो सब होने ही वाला है डायरिया nausea, vomiting, fever, etc., etc. This is a potent side effect. Again, this is a hepatotoxic drug. Okay. So this is basically I want to share with you that why we should search for new NTTB drugs. Because already drugs which are used, they are having side effects. Isoniazid causing hepatotoxicity, ethambutol that is causing hepatotoxicity and optical neuritis. We should definitely work for in a search of new NTTB therapeutic uses. It can be used in pulmonary TB, pulmonary TB, a kind of TB which is where the patients will develop tuberculosis of the lungs. Extra pulmonary TB means other than the tuberculosis, other than pulmonary TB. It can be whether, say, let us say, TB of kidney or TB of brain, etc., etc. So this is also possible. TB of brain tabhi hota hai, the Mycobacterium tuberculosis can cause deposition or accumulation into the brain. If it cause blood-brain barrier and go to certain parts of the brain and cause infection. ક્યારેક જો કોઈને સમય સાંભળ્યું હોય તો એવું કહે છે કે હા મગજનું ઇન્ફેક્શન થઈ ગયું છે. Sometimes we have to identify whether it is Mycobacterium tuberculosis or it is Streptococcus bacteria or some other kind of bacteria. In such case, doctor will do the lumbar puncture at the back of the spinal cord and will take the spinal fluid, around 2 ml of the spinal fluid by the lumbar puncture. And that sample can be accessed for the presence, to check the presence of microorganisms. As Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Streptococcus, or some other. Check whether it is meningitis or some other kinds of tuberculosis. Just I came to discuss this, I have discussed with this to explain you people that khali aisa nahi hai ki TB khali lungs mein hi hota hai. TB is also possible for kidney, also possible for brain and some other organs, depending upon the accumulation of Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Yeah. So in pulmonary TB as well as extra pulmonary TB, this ethambutol is a drug which can be, and it is given in combination therapy at least for 48 days, isoniazid, pyrazine and okay, now the last class of the drug which we have to learn today, that is this rifampicin or rifampin. So friends, basically this rifampin or rifampicin, that is called a kind of ensamycin. I mean to say, if you see the structure of this drug, I have the structure, no, I have not kept the structure over here, but if you search on this rifampicin, so you will come to know that this drug is having a macrocyclic ring structure. In next lecture, I will present the structure on this. And that is basically going to inhibit RNA polymerase enzyme. That is going to inhibit RNA polymerase enzyme. It will prevent the RNA synthesis in such way, and that it is going to inhibit the protein. Refer Rungen medicinal chemistry by, or sorry, if you refer the pharmacology by Rungendale, very nicely they have given a kind of transcription and translation which can occur in mycobacteria or in which can occur in any bacteria, where how several drugs can affect pathogenesis of microorganisms. Okay, so this is basically useful in treatment of Mycobacterium avium cellularly complex, that is called MSC. So when basically ये कब होता है, सो माइकोबैक्टीरियम ट्यूबरकुलोसिस की वजह से भी इंफेक्शन है और स्टेफाइलोकोकस की वजह से भी इंफेक्शन है. सो इन दैट केस माइकोबैक्टीरियम ट्यूबरकुलोसिस, माइकोबैक्टीरियम एवियम कॉम्प्लेक्स इंफेक्शन के टाइम पे रिफामपिसिन, और बहुत सारे इसके टाइप है, रिफामपिसिन ए बी सी डी ई, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दिस ड्रग्स रिफामपिसिन. एंड दिस इज अ ड्रग ऑफ 1957. Right, so it is long back ago. Drug is still used. Yeah, right. So mechanism of action is DNA dependent RNA polymerase inhibitor, or you can also call them as RNA polymerase. It not only inhibit Mycobacterium tuberculosis, but also it inhibits gram positive bacteria. Okay, this is also antibacterial. Okay, and this is a dose and etc. Major side effect of a drug is that this is actually, when it is given to the patient, it will cause coloration of the body fluids. I think it is mentioned here or not, I'm not sure. But this has been provided in this medicine chemist. KDT में भी होगा और आप इंडियन डेल पढ़ो तो उसमें भी दिया. So this drug is basically a kind of dye. Dye means which is generally used in dye industry for the purpose of making some materials colorful. तो उसी तरह का ही एक कंपाउंड है, रिफाम्पिन भी बोलते हैं उसको, रिफाम्पिसिन भी बोल सकते हैं, तो दोनों ही नाम सही है, उसमें कुछ गलत नहीं है, रिफाम्पिन भी है और रिफाम्पिसिन भी. When this drug is administered to the patient, then body fluids of the patient, such as salivary or sorry, such as the salivary fluids, so that will become orange because it is a chemical, it is a dye, and the urine of the patient will also become orange color or orange tint color, sometimes yellow color, depending upon the administered dose of rifampin or rifampicin. तो उससे पेशेंट का जो यूरिन का कलर है वो भी चेंज होता है. इसलिए दिस इज ऑलवेज यूज टू गिव द एडवाइस टू द पेशेंट, हाँ आप जो ये दवाई ले रहे हो ना उससे आपका यूरिन जो है वो पिंक कलर का या ऑरेंज कलर का आएगा, आपको डरने की जरूरत नहीं है, ये नेचुरली सारे पेशेंट्स में देखने को मिलता है. If we, as a pharmacist or if as a physician, if a doctor prescribes while prescribing the medicine, if such kinds of instructions are also given to the patients, then patient will feel okay. वरना क्या होगा कि पे डॉक्टर भी जल्दी जल्दी में भूल जाता है और फार्मासिस्ट भी भूल जाता है, खाना खाना होता है या फिर उसका कुछ काम है तो भूल गया है बोलने को. हाँ, दिस इयर इफ यू आर टेकिंग सो एंड सो ड्रग, यू विल हैव योर बॉडी फ्लूइड्स सच एज योर सलाइवा, sometimes your urine or sometimes your lacrimal fluid also may develop some discoloration such as orange, red or pale yellow kind of that. We have to advise the patients like this. If we don't advise, then what will happen patient when we will see go to the toilet and we'll see the urine orange in color, तो उसको लगेगा अरे मेरे पेशाब में तो लहू आ गया है, खून आ गया है, तो he will be panic at that time. To avoid that kind of things, we should instruct the patient that this is a drug, rifampicin, which can cause discoloration of the urine. Right? So it is not hematuria. Hematuria is a condition where a patient's urine will have blood. So it is not hematuria, but it is a kind of simple discoloration of body fluids. Okay. So, friends, here we will stop ourselves on this slide. In coming lectures, we will discuss the further anti-TB drugs which are used in treatment of tuberculosis. So, we will stop ourselves from this onwards. So, thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.